हम अहमद बच्चे
हैं
कुछ करके
दिखा
देंगे।
Welcome to a new episode of Children's Corner. For the next half an hour, we will watch three segments: Tajweed-ul-Quran, Let's Ask, and of course, Sketch. So let's start with Tajweed-ul-Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Children, welcome back to the segment Tahseen-ul-Quran, Beautification of the Holy Quran with the recitation of the Holy Quran. You remember that in last segment I discussed about the four important components of a good tilawat. The first one was phonetics, makharij, exit point, points of articulation, that each letter should be pronounced with its due qualities, and we should keep in mind the similar sounding letter. And also the second one is prolongation and shortening the voice where is needed, and also assimilation, the joining of letters and verses and the words. And also the fourth one is the knowledge of pauses, where to stop and from where to start, what are the rules. Now we will listen to a tilawat in this segment of ابتسام احمد طاهر
يا ايها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون الذي جعل لكم الارض فراشا والسماء بناء أو أن نزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا وأنتم تعلمون.
Okay, Jazakumullah Ibtisam. Thank you very much. And he is quite young, Tifl. Alhamdulillah, he has a good voice and he has pronounced beautifully. I like to highlight two, three points. First of all is a prolongation of Fatha or Kasra or Dhamma, which is commonly known in Asian countries as Zer, Zabar and Pesh. Now, Fatha, a slanting stroke over a letter, must not be pronounced more than 1 second. One normal blink of eye, one beat, not more than that. Otherwise, meaning could be changed. And in last segment, I gave the example of La. If Lam with Fatha is followed by Alif, which is a harfe madda, letter prolongation, it means not. But if Lam it only with one slanting fatha without any addition of alif, it means sure. Now apart from this one, he should keep in mind or should practice that wherever fatha, kasra, dhamma, he should not pronounce more than 1 second. Second one in that in the word as-sama, Hamza has been omitted. So this word is not complete without pronouncing Hamza with Fatha. As-sama'a. And again the word as-thamarat. As-thamarat, Ra has a vertical Fatha on that one. So it should be pronounced with 2 seconds duration. But it has been pronounced with fatha, not with vertical fatha. Should be given 2 normal blinks of eye time or 2 beats. And the same mistake was repeated in the word andada. Dal is followed by Alif, which is a letter of prolongation, a harf-e madda. So it should be prolonged 2 seconds, 2 beats, the duration of 2 normal blinks of eyes. Apart from this, I think this is a good tilawat, and I encourage Ibtisam to continue, mashallah. And let's listen to the next tilawat, which is from Arslan Sabir.
Alif Lam Mim Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fi Hudal Lil-Muttaqin Allazina Yu'minuna Bil-Ghaybi Wa Yuqimuna As-Salata Wa Mimma Razaqnahum Yunfekun.
Okay, thank you. Again, I like to mention that last time I mentioned about 2 levels. One is the basic level. So I am highlighting the mistakes or the common errors, keeping in mind the basic level of Yasal Quran because of their age group. So, and in this age group, the most important point is to prolong the certain letters whenever they have a harfe madda after that one, and those letters which have only fatha, kasra, dhamma, 3 basic strokes, they should not be prolonged more than 1 second. And here are the common errors which are pronounced by people which we should avoid. Again, la raiba fi. La has been pronounced with a shorter voice. It should be pronounced with a good duration, as I mentioned in the previous example. And whenever you are making or joining 2 words or in a flow of recitation, there should not be a cut in between the 2 words without making a pause, without the rules of pause. Yu'minuna, noon has been given a more time as you know, as it was needed. So there is a fatha and only a fatha for 1 second. Again, yuqimuna, again there is a problem of prolongation has not been done properly. Apart from this, I think he should also need a continuous practice, daily practice, at least reciting 2 rukus on daily basis. Then he should have a good flow of the recitation, which is also very much required according to the word tartil, which has been given by Allah the Almighty as a command that you should recite the Holy Quran with tartil. With these 2 examples, we conclude this segment, and inshallah ta'ala, in the next segment we will play other more tilawat. Until the next program, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
You can call the number on your screen and record your tilawat on voicemail. We will then select and play them in future programs. But for now, let's move on to Let's Ask.
Assalamu alaikum viewers, I'm Rahman, your host for this segment. In this segment we find answers to questions most children have in mind. Do you have a question? Please feel free to write to us on the email address being shown on the screen right now. Today in the studio we have with us Amir Pai, who is a teacher by profession. Assalamu alaikum Amir Pai.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
Amir Pai, you know what? I really love Huzur, but who is he and what is it that makes him so special?
That's a very good question. Huzur is very special to a lot of people, all the Ahmadis in the world. He is the leader to all of them. But what makes him super special and absolutely unique is the fact that he is selected by Allah. He does not do the job voluntarily. Yeah. He is divinely guided and we love him and he loves us. What makes him so special is the fact that he is the only one that's chosen by Allah. You would respect the king of a country,
yeah.
Except Huzur is even more than that, because if you think about it, there are Ahmadis all over the world and he is in charge of all of them.
Yeah.
So he is even more important than a king.
Well, you've just mentioned that God directly chooses Huzur, but I thought he was elected, so why the election?
Yes, that's a very good question, and I'm going to try and answer it. You see, when a prophet is chosen and he has no community, he has to be told directly by Allah. He has to be chosen and told directly by Allah. But when the prophet passes away, he leaves a community behind. And Allah then gives the right to the community to make a choice and to vote for the person who is most right to lead the community.
Jazakallah. Amir Pai, you know what? I've just noticed that I've seen all of these pictures in my house. Well, I really want to know more about them. Can you explain?
Yes, these. These are the pictures of the Khalifas. The first picture is the picture of the first Khalifa, and his name was Hazrat Hakim Nuruddin, radiallahu anhu. The second picture is of the second Khalifa, and he came when the first Khalifa passed away. The second Khalifa's name is Hazrat Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The third picture that you see is of the third Khalifa. His name is Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmad, rahimullah alayh. The fourth picture is of the fourth Khalifa, and his name is Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad, rahimullah alayh. And the fifth picture, do you know who that is?
Yeah, that's Huzur.
That's correct, and his full name is Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad. May Allah strengthen his hands.
Jazakallah, that has really helped us understand.
Good. I just wanted to say one more thing though, before we carry on, before you ask me your next question. And that is that all of the pictures that you see, all of the Khalifas of Ahmadiyyat, are all successors of the promised Messiah, and not of each other. So all the Khalifas, that's why they're called Khalifatul Masih. They are all Khalifas of the promised Messiah, alayhi salam.
Okay, Jazakallah, that has really helped us understand. Before we go, can I ask you just one last question? As I said, we all really love Huzur, but everyone wants to get close to him. So how do we get closer to him?
There are many ways in which you can get close to him. And I would advise you, and indeed this is an advice for all Ahmadi children and all Ahmadis in general, you should write to Huzur on a regular basis. And write to him, when you do write to him, ask him for prayers and ask him for advice for any issues that you may have.
Okay, Jazakallah. And just for the viewers at home, what address do you write to?
Yes, of course, the standard address to write to is 16 Gresson Hall Road, London, SW18 5QL.
Jazakallah, Mirpay. That's it for today. Do join us next week where we'll have more questions and more answers. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Drawing, painting and sketching can be real fun. So let's watch Sketch.
Assalamu alaikum viewers, my name is Masood Ahmed Tahir and welcome back to Sketch. In this program, we're going to show you how to draw characters. But in this segment, we're going to show you how to draw cartoon characters. One of the most important features in a cartoon character is the eyes. Depending on the eyes, you can tell if they're smiling, if they're sad, if they're angry, if they're excited. So let's try something right now. Right now, I'm going to do a happy face. So let's start off with the eyebrows. For a happy face, you might want to do uplifted eyebrows. So you might have to do like a cylinder shape. Give them big eyes. And always give them that little tiny sparkle. Just fill it in. Remember, one of the most important parts are the eyebrows. So depending on how you color the eyebrows, that will judge how, if they're smiling or if they're angry, or even if they're upset. Like, give them big ones. Yeah, now let's call this one happy. Let's try an angry one. Give him a mean V-shaped eyebrow. Have the eyeballs right underneath the eyebrows. And this time, give him smaller eyes. Let's call that one angry. Let's try a more confused look. Call this confused. Now for a confused look, you might want to try a different shape in eyebrows. So, one eyebrow will always be like straight, and the other one will be like an S shape. So like an S shape. Have the eyes underneath the eyebrows. And this time give them smaller eyes. And when you're done with that, let's try and give them, let's say, a neutral look, so they have no expressions on their face. Give them straight eyebrows. And just have a half a circle underneath their eyebrows. Almost makes them look like they don't care. And once again, this time give them great big eyes. And once again, it's a half a circle. Give them that slight sparkle right there in the corner. Fill that in. Let's call that not caring. Let's try another one. How about, let's say, an excited look? Again, it'll be slightly similar to the happy look. But this time, make the eyebrows slightly higher than the eyes. And this time, have the eyes slightly smaller. Like that. Okay, what other look is there? Okay, let's call that a surprised. Now let's try something slightly trickier. Let's try a sad look this time. A sad one will be similar to the happy one, but it'll be the other way around. So instead of a happy look, let's try a sad. You might want to reverse the happy look. and have the eyes directly under the eyebrows. Give them great big eyes. And have a slight twinkle in the eye as well. Make them look like they're crying or give a C-shaped twinkle. And get that filled in. That filled in right there. And depending on the boldness of the lines, it will show you how much impact it has on the character. So if we go back to the happy look, you can tell that the thinness of the lines show that he's more excited and his eyes are bigger because he's happy. The angry look should be slightly bolder. You want the boldness of the lines so you can give him that mean look. Okay. All right. Okay. This is sad. Okay, and this is what we've done so far. If you've been trying it, you should have something similar to this. So, if you want, you can send in your work to the address shown on your TV right now. And until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
That's it for today. Join us next week, same day and same time. Assalamu alaikum.
Zulmat mita denge, nooron se basa denge. Hum Ahmadi bacche hain, kuch karke dikha denge. Shaitan ki hukumat ko duniya se mita denge. Hum Ahmadi bacche.